Welcome back to Harbaugh. Just 3 weeks from now, in fact, tomorrow, a handful of crucial states will determine whether Democrats keep a majority in the United States Senate or whether Republicans get control among those battleground states in North Carolina, where the race to the finish line is intensifying even as we speak. We're there this weekend, and here's what we found. With control of the U.S. Senate in the balance, Harbaugh took to the road this weekend to check out the race in North Carolina. It's where Democrat Kay Hagan is in a tough fight with Tom Tillis, her testy Republican opponent.
Usually races like this that are this close kind of bounce back and forth, but she's kind of maintained a stubborn 2 to 5 point lead nonstop for the last 6 weeks or so.
The latest polling has Hagan up by 2 points, 47 to 45. I asked Senator Hagan what she thinks will decide it in November.
I think voter turnout is the key. It's certainly a key in my election in an off presidential election year. We know that voter turnout goes down, and I have put together one of the biggest voter turnout operations we've ever seen in North Carolina.
But new voting restrictions passed by the conservative North Carolina legislature might affect turnout on election day.
Their intent was to suppress Democratic turnout, and it's wrong. People have fought and died for this constitutional right to vote. And if you look at what they did, they took away a number of early voting days. They took away same-day registration. We actually allowed in civics classes as a senior in high school that students could register to vote. They took that away. You want to ask yourself why.
Hagan's Republican opponent, Tom Tillis, is the Speaker of the House in the North Carolina legislature. He was the one who pushed for these new voting restrictions, which he must have known would weigh heaviest on his Democratic rival.
Did he lead the fight, as you see it, to suppress the vote?
Yes. I mean, when you look at the voter intimidation, these barriers to the ballot box, I contacted Eric Holder, two states in the nation that he brought suit in, North Carolina and Texas, because of the egregious violation of the constitutional right to vote. It is 2014. Why would Speaker Tom Tillis put barriers up to the ballot box today? It's wrong. And that's exactly what they've done.
The restrictions are expected to hurt African-American voters the most. ACP has been leading the fight to inform black voters of their rights.
What do you think this voter suppression is all about? Is it partisan or racist? What is it? Or both?
I think it's both. The numbers show it, that the population of people that's going to be affected the most is African Americans.
Yeah. What happened is that there are some people who don't want to see progress. But, you know, the real question is these folks here in the NAACP in North Carolina do want to see it. And so they're leading the nation, because this is where the action is. This is where the leadership is, right here.
Among those leaders is the Reverend William Barber, a civil rights advocate in the Tar Heel State.
When you talk to Republicans, and I think you do, about why they push for these new voter laws, do they admit it's suppression?
Well, you know, Tom Tillis admitted on MSNBC, there's a tape where he said it wasn't about fraud. He admitted that.
Not only that, but Speaker Tillis said the true intent of the new laws is to prevent fraud that might occur in the future.
Why is this a legislative priority?
Well, we call this restoring confidence in elections. There is some voter fraud, but that's not the primary reason for doing this. There's a lot of people who are just concerned with the potential risk of fraud, and in our state, it could be significant.
Reverend Barber gained wide recognition for leading Moral Mondays in North Carolina, a weekly protest movement with civil rights and voting fairness at the top of its agenda.
We talk about what's constitutionally inconsistent. We've had Republicans and Democrats stand on the Moral Monday stage and say, any politicians, Chris, that will get elected and then use their power to keep people from voting, it's wrong.
Senator Hagan has, for her part, made voting rights a key component of her reelection fight.
We need to have a huge turnout on November the 4th. With your help and support, we are going to get out the voters. We're going to inform them, tell them what the rules of the road are. This election is that critical.
Based on racism, or on partisanship, why are they trying to screw the black voter, to put it bluntly? Is it because they don't like blacks or because they don't like Democrats?
You know, I think they are trying to suppress Democratic turnout.
So it's
plain and simple. I mean, Sundays to the polls, done away. The whole early voting concept, people have early and, I mean, busy lives. They want to go and vote early. And to think you take another week of that away, that's wrong. Yeah. That is really wrong.
But African Americans think that they're being targeted because they're African Americans, not because they're Democrats.
Well, you know, I tend to agree with them.
Some say Tillis might trigger a voter backlash for his push to enact these new voter restrictions. It could cause African Americans to show up in even greater numbers at a protest.
From what I can tell, the state's voter ID laws are motivating the base like nothing I've ever seen. I think that the Republican Party overreached to such an extent that they're going to have a hard time for the next couple of cycles because they're going to have to own what they've done.
The consequences of these new laws are far-reaching and could even determine which party wins control of the U.S. Senate. Every vote in a battleground state like North Carolina counts. Every vote that gets suppressed does too.